Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain about perimeter and perimeter of triangle, perimeter of square, and perimeter of rectangle. And you might have learned about these concepts in class 5th and class 4th. Let us once again, we can recall all these concepts once again so that we can use these concepts to solve the problems. Okay. So, what is perimeter, children? See, perimeter the word. Perimeter is the distance covered along the boundary forming a closed figure when you go around the figure once. It's called a perimeter. So, perimeter means, once again, is the distance covered along the boundary forming a closed figure when you go around the figure once, children. So, let us find out the perimeter of rectangle, children. P of rectangle, perimeter of rectangle. So, perimeter of rectangle, children. So, how to calculate, how to get the formula to find out the perimeter of rectangle, children? See, draw the figure, children. Rectangle figure you can draw. This is the breadth, this is length, this is the breadth, this is length. Okay, breadth, length, children. Generally, perimeter of rectangle equal to sum of the lengths of four sides. Length of four sides. Children, you know very well. So P of rectangle equal to B plus L, children. Breadth, length, children. Now that implies, you know very well, therefore 2 into B plus L, breadth into length, breadth plus L, B plus or L plus B, anything you can have, children. All is going to children like this. 2B plus 2L. That is 2 into B plus L. Length into breadth. Length plus breadth. B plus L. Okay. So therefore, P of rectangle equal to 2 into L plus B or B plus L. L plus B also or 2 into L plus B. So this is the equation for to find out the perimeter of a rectangle, children. To find out the perimeter of a rectangle. So once again, how to calculate, how to find the formula perimeter of a square, children. Perimeter of a square. So perimeter of a square, P of square. No doubt, children, you write square diagram, brother said square diagram. Children, here, after here, all the sides, yes. So, P of square equal to, P of square equal to, children, you can remember, P of square equal to 4 into length of its sides, 4 into length of any sides. That means what? 4 into length of any side, that implies 4 into S. So 4 into S is the perimeter of the formula P into S. 4 into S, P of square, perimeter of a square. Now children, for example, see how to calculate, how to find the perimeter of an equilateral triangle. So perimeter of an equilateral triangle, children, see, perimeter of an equilateral triangle, P of equilateral triangle. P of is what? Perimeter of equilateral triangle, children. Suppose you draw the figure triangle. In equilateral triangle, children, all the sides are same, children. In equilateral triangle, all the sides are same. That means what? If all the sides are same, so that, for example, see 4 centimeters, this also 4 centimeters, and this also 4 centimeters. Therefore, P of triangle equal to 3 into length of any side. 3 into length of any side. Length of any side. So this is the formula for perimeter of a triangle, children. Perimeter of a triangle. Okay, so we have learnt
perimeter of rectangle, perimeter of square, and perimeter of a triangle, children. So, how to find the perimeter of regular polygons? Polygons, children, what is polygons? A simple closed figure containing two or more sides. A simple closed figure containing two or more sides is called polygon. So, how to find perimeter of a regular polygon, children? So, regular polygon, nothing but you can take square, rectangle, triangle, etc. Of course, you can take pentagon, hexagon, octagon, okay, etc. These are all regular polygons. So, for example, to find out the perimeter of a five-sided regular polygon, how to find out the perimeter of a five-sided regular polygon, children? Simply, here the five-sided regular polygon is a pentagon. So, therefore, the five-sided regular polygon equal to perimeter of five-sided regular polygon equal to 5 into length of any side. Like that, six-sided regular polygon hexagon equal to 6 into length of any side. Like that, perimeter of a regular eight-sided polygon octagon equal to 8 into length of any side, children. Okay, children? So, find the perimeter of a regular polygon of side 8 centimeter, children. So, how to calculate the regular perimeter of a regular polygon, children? See here, find the perimeter of regular pentagon of side 8 centimeter. Pentagon is what, children? Just I draw the pentagon. Okay, this pentagon, children. So, each side is 8 centimeters. This also 8 centimeters. This also 8 centimeters. This also 8 centimeters. This also 8 centimeters. Therefore, P of regular five-sided, that is pentagon, equal to what, children, here? 8 into length of any side. 8 into length of. 8 into number of sides. What is? See, that is what here? 8 into 5. 8 into number of sides. 8 into number of sides, children. Number of sides. That means what? 8 into 5, children. Equal to how much answer? 40 centimeters. We can take it as a 40 centimeter, children. So, one more sum I will tell you, children, how to calculate. Children, here one more example sum I will tell you. See here, find the cost of fencing a square park of side 250 meters at the rate of 24 meters, children. Okay, find the cost of fencing a square park upside 250 meters at the rate of 20 per meter. Children, you know very well, square fencing is there here. Okay, one second, square fencing, children, square fencing. So, this is square park. Okay, now, already given, side how much? Side of a square equal to how much given here? Side of a square park equal to 250 meters. So, side of a square park equal to 250 meters, children. Now, perimeter of the square park equal to P of square park equal to 4 into 250 meters, children. That implies which what? 4 into 250 meters, children. This what? 1000 meters. So, P of a square park equal to 4 into 250 meters, that is equal to 1000 meters. Okay. Now, rate of fencing the park. Per meter equal to
20 per meter.
Per equal to 20 per meter. 20 per meter, children. Now, the total cost of fencing the park equal to, I am writing it here, total park of fencing the park equal to, you know, 1000 into 20 rupees, children. That is 2000
or 20,000 rupees.
20,000 rupees, children. So like that, we can do the sums by using the formula, children. Okay, by using the formula, you can do the sums. And one more important thing is very simple, children. One more sum I would like to explain you. Based on rectangular shapes. Okay, thank you, children. You can continue the remaining sums.